You're probably saying, okay, Renato, that's enough with all the theoretical stuff about federalism. I want to understand the federalism in Australia. I want to understand the federal system in Australia. I don't get it. Please, please, please help me. Well, I hear your claim and I'm here to help you. So today we are going to study about Australian federalism. Hello everyone, my name is Renato Costa and this is Aussie Law. If you don't want to miss any of our videos, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell sign, because that way you're gonna be notified every time I upload a new video and you're not gonna miss out on anything about constitutional law in Australia. So, without further ado, are you ready to understand Australian federalism? In another video, I said that federalism is probably the most important principle of Australian constitution. That is, federalism is the vibe.
That's it, it's the vibe.
So how does this play out in practice? In Australia, a normal citizen is subjected to two different levels of government. You can use two different court systems. You can elect two different governments and some other things as well. But basically we have these two levels, the federal level and the state's level. The two are completely intertwined and interdependent, but they are still autonomous and distinct. Most of the things you need to know about the Commonwealth and its relationship with the states are laid out in the Commonwealth of Australia Constitution Act of 1901. As you already know, we made a video about that act. You can watch it by clicking the top right corner. It is there, in the Constitution, that you will find the distribution of powers, the jurisdiction, the structure, and the organization of the Federal Commonwealth. But you don't have to read the whole thing right now. I'll walk you through it. Allow me, then, to start by refreshing your memory with some things that we have already established in our previous videos. 1. Australia is a federation. It is not a confederation. The other thing is that Federal Australia was the result of an aggregation. The former colonies united and formed one indissoluble Commonwealth. I said indissoluble, so one state cannot just decide by itself to leave and dissolve the federation. And also, Australia is a coordinative federation. That means that each level has their own responsibilities. Each government has their own jurisdiction. Now let's start with the composition. What is the Australian Federation composed of? There is first the federal entity. It did not exist prior, but was the resulting political body out of the covenant, the agreement made by the former colonies of New South Wales, Victoria, Tasmania, South Australia, Western Australia and Queensland. This sphere was only created with the enactment of the Constitution. Section 3 of the Constitution Act said that the former colonies would unite into a federal Commonwealth under the name of the Commonwealth of Australia. So the federal entity is called the Commonwealth of Australia. Despite some people saying that the name actually remembered a form of republicanism, it stuck and we still use it today. And I'll tell you this. Commonwealth of Australia is definitely a better name than the United States of Australia. That's for sure. The term Commonwealth is composed of two parts, common and weal or wealth. It literally means common good or common well-being. From there, it came to mean the body politic or the whole of the people in a state. I personally like the name because it kind of represents what the state is for. The state exists for the common good of the people, and that's what Commonwealth is all about. And if you think about it, that's the reason why the Australian states exist. It's to facilitate the cooperation between the people of the states and promote the common good for the people of the states. So, do you see that the existence of the federal Commonwealth is actually predicated in the existence of the states? The federal Commonwealth was created because of the states, not the other way around. That's why James Price has said about federations that it is a state which while one is nevertheless composed of other states even more essential to its existence than it is to theirs. But this also doesn't mean that the Commonwealth doesn't do much other than just intermediate between the states. The Federal Commonwealth has its own role. It is the national body. It represents Australia as a nation. It is the national entity, an entity that is responsible for the whole of the people in Australia. While each state will take care of their own, the Commonwealth is responsible for taking care of everyone. This kind of became a little bit clear with the pandemic, right? We saw the states, each one really concerned about their own and closing their borders and taking care of the people inside their jurisdiction, and the Commonwealth trying to intermediate and take care of the people as a whole. At the federal level, we have three branches of power: the executive, the legislature, and the judiciary. The federal executive is composed of the Queen, the Governor General, the ministers, and the ministerial departments. You can find out more about them in Chapter 2 of the Constitution. The federal legislature is the Australian Parliament, meets in Canberra, and is divided into the House of Representatives and the Senate. You find out more about that in Chapter 1 of the Australian Constitution. And the federal judiciary, that you can find out more in Chapter 3 of the Constitution, is composed of federal circuit courts, federal courts, family courts, and the full federal court, and of course the High Court of Australia. In next videos, we're going to learn more about provisions of the Constitution, constitutional cases, and also we will understand a bit more about these institutions, these elements that compose these institutions, and we are going to understand them in the context of the Australian Federation as a whole. But for now, let's turn to the states. The states are the second level of the Federation in Australia. Australia is constituted by the Federal Commonwealth, the six states, and some territories. If you want to understand more about the territories, what they are, and what's the relationship between the territories and the states, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell sign, because my next video will explain everything that you need to know about the differences between the Australian states and the Australian territories. So, six states: Queensland, New South Wales, Victoria, Tasmania, South Australia, and Western Australia. Each one has their own constitutions, but the national constitution, the Australian constitution, has specific sections and chapters and provisions about the states and new states. These constitutional provisions related to the states are specially contained in Chapter 5 of the Australian Constitution. The deal with the states is that they're supposed to be equal in status and in power. And this is the fruit of the bargaining that occurred pre-federation. The idea of federation, and we talked about it already, is to potentialize certain bonus, like having a shared protection, but at the same time diminish the onus, like losing certain powers. So it's because of that environment that we can say that the states try to be equal. They're not going to accept in a bargaining that one state will be more important than the other. They are really sharing the responsibility and the status in the federation. Sir Samuel Griffith, a Queensland lawyer who was brilliant and who became the first Chief Justice in the High Court of Australia, said that the essential and preliminary condition of federation was that the separate states are to continue as autonomous bodies, surrendering only so much of their powers as is necessary to the establishment of a general government to do for them collectively what they cannot do individually for themselves, and which they cannot do as a collective body for themselves. Did you get the gist of it? When the states are negotiating to create the federal Commonwealth, they do want to share certain powers and they want to potentialize those powers. But to do that, they're not willing to just give up everything that they own, like their distinctiveness and the individualities of their jurisdiction, of their states. Federations are about shared rule, but they're also about self-rule. And the states, the six Australian states, will do their best to keep those powers to themselves. I've talked about that in our previous video. I compare that situation to the situation of baking a cake together with someone. Just don't forget to watch that video as well. So, as a whole, it is a characteristic of Australian federalism that the states will remain autonomous and equal. And just like the federal sphere, the states also have three branches of power. The executive is composed of the governor, who is the representative of the queen in the state, and the premier, who is kind of like the prime minister, but in the state. And also all of the ministers, the representatives that will form the government. The legislature is composed of two houses. They are bicameral. There is a lower house and an upper house. Queensland is the only unicameral state in Australia because the upper house, the Legislative Assembly, was abolished in 1922. The two mainland territories, the ACT and the Northern Territory, they are also unicameral, but all the other states are bicameral. And the judiciary of the states is composed of the Magistrate Court, the Appeal Court, and the Supreme Court of the state. And also the High Court of Australia, who sits at the apex of the judicial system in the states as well. This is the structure and the composition of the Australian federalism in a nutshell. But there's still one more thing that I would like to say before ending this video. I feel I must say a little bit more about Sir Henry Parkes, because he is known as the father of the Australian Federation. Just so you have an idea, in 2001, the Reserve Bank of Australia issued a commemorative $5 banknote with the face of Sir Henry Parkes in it. It was issued for the commemoration of 100 years of the Federation, and his face appeared there, so you can imagine how important he is for Australian federalism. During the conventions to create the Australian Federation and to draft the Constitution, Henry Parkes set out certain resolutions, and I want to use these resolutions as a summary of the Australian federal system. So, here we go. Are you ready? These are the resolutions from Henry Parkes, and these are basically what he wanted to ensure the Australian federal system would look like. He wanted that the powers, the privileges, and the territorial rights of the colonies remained intact after federation. He also wanted trade and intercourse between the federated states to be absolutely free. The third resolution was that the federal parliament was to be composed of two bodies, a House of Representatives and a Senate. The Senate was going to be the House of the States, and it will have the same amount of seats for each state. In the Constitution, that number of seats was set to 6, but today, each state has 12 senators. And the House of Representatives was the house of the whole of the Commonwealth. It was to represent the whole of the people, and that's why the representatives are elected on a population basis. The fourth resolution was that there was to be a federal court to be the highest court in all of Australia. And resolution number 5 was that the federal executive government would be responsible to the lower house of federal parliament. This is the idea behind the principle of responsible government. It is another very important principle in the Australian Constitution, and I will make a video about it very soon. Well, I hope you liked this video. If you did, don't forget to click the like button, and I hope to see you next time as well. Until then, ciao!